learned and become and shared it with others.
Today's Gospel, Jesus commanded us to love others as he has loved us. Let us pray during this Mass that we may have a safe and fun summer and be examples of God's love for all.
The opening song is number 162. Alleluia, love is life. Number 162.
Good morning, everyone. It is such a joy to be able to gather together to celebrate this last day of school. All together as a school community and many of the parents and grandparents here, welcome to everyone who has joined us. Let us pray together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May the grace and peace of God the Father who has raised Jesus Christ from the dead be with you all. Our brothers and sisters, let us take a moment to think about our sins, to tell God that we are sorry for our sins, and to pray for his forgiveness and mercy. Lord Jesus, you came to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You intercede for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, almighty and merciful God, that we may in truth receive a share in the resurrection of Christ your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The crowd joined in the attack on Paul and Silas. Then the officials tore the clothes off the two men and ordered them to be beaten. After they had been badly beaten, they were put in jail. And the jailer was told to guard them carefully. The jailer did as he was told. He put them deep inside the jail and chained their feet to a stake. About midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing praise to God. While the other prisoners listened, suddenly a strong earthquake shook the jail to its foundation. Then the doors opened and the chains fell from all the prisoners. When the jailer woke up and saw that the doors were open, he thought that the prisoners had escaped. He pulled out his sword and was about to kill himself. But Paul shouted, "Do not harm yourself. No one has escaped."
The jailer asked for a torch and went into the jail. He was shaking all over as he knelt down in front of Paul and Silas. After he had led them out of the jail, he asked, "What must I do to be saved?" They replied, "Have faith in the Lord Jesus, and you will be saved. This is also true for everyone who lives in your home." Then Paul and Silas told him and everyone else in his house about the Lord. While it was still night, the jailer took them to a place where he could wash their cuts and bruises. Then he and everyone in his home were baptized with the word of the Lord.
Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you.
Jesus said to his disciples, "This is my commandment. Love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I've called you friends because I've told you everything I've heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you, and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you, love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Most all of us know that Jesus' great command is to love one another. That is what he tells us in the gospel today. We are to love one another. But that word love, we use quite a bit. By show of hands, how many people here love that this is the last day of school? Almost everyone. Now let me ask you this. How many of you love school? Quite a few of you. Not as many as love the last day of school, but there's still quite a few. How many here love pizza? Quite a few. How many love your parents? Grandparents? Brothers and sisters? Okay, some hands went down. We use that word love a lot, don't we? We use it to describe really liking or being excited about stuff that is happening, stuff that we enjoy. We talk about loving things. And then also the love that we have for people, especially important and significant people in our lives. We use that word a lot, but it doesn't always mean the same, right? You love your parents, and you love pizza. Is that the same kind of love? No, not really. Loving school and loving your grandparents, is that the same kind of love? No, because there's a difference when you're dealing with people and when you're dealing with things. But we use that word a lot, and actually, when the Bible was first written, it was written in Greek. And the Greek have many words for love. And when it's translated into English, all of them are just translated as love. But the word that Jesus uses, words that scripture scholars or the scripture writers use, is agape or agape. And that's the kind of love that doesn't have to do with feelings. It's not really having excitement. It doesn't mean that it excludes that. It still can be part of that. But what Jesus is saying when he loves us and he wants us to love one another is wanting the very best for the other. Willing to make sacrifices for the other. Willing to put someone else's needs ahead of our own. Because that's exactly what Jesus did. Jesus says, "My command is that you love one another as I love you." And Jesus is speaking this to his disciples the night before he dies, the night of the Last Supper. He was his disciples and he's giving them these last instructions. And he's saying, this is what I want you to do. I want you to love each other like I love you. And as we celebrate the Eucharist this morning, we come together and remember that. That Jesus gave himself for us. He was willing to die on the cross for us. For our sins. Because he wants the very best for us. He doesn't want us to continue to carry our sins around, so he offers us his forgiveness and mercy. And ultimately, he wants us to spend eternity with him. He wants us to be with him forever in heaven. He wants the very best for us. And that's the kind of love that we're to have for one another. That willing to sacrifice. To do things sometimes not because we always feel like doing it, but because it's the right thing to do out of love. Now, when I was a kid, when I was growing up, one of the things that my dad would often want us to do is go visit my great-grandma. Now, I didn't like visiting my great-grandma, not because I didn't like her. She was a great person. But because on the way over there, we'd be going over, you are to walk in, you're to say hello to grandma, and then you're to sit and be quiet the whole time. And you couldn't say anything, not disturb the adults when they're talking, not make a lot of noise, and just visit. Now, how many would love that? A few. I didn't. I didn't like doing that. But I did it for a couple reasons. One, we know we're supposed to be obedient to our parents, right? And to do what they say. And so, out of obedience, went. But also, as I got older, started to understand it's the right thing to do. My great-grandma loved seeing us, loved spending time with us. And it was important to her, and even though I didn't like doing it, it was important to do it. By a show of hands, you already said about how many love going to school. How many people love going to school every day? I remember one of my nieces, when she was in kindergarten, came home and said, I didn't think this was going to be every day. She likes school a little bit, but not every day, not 5 days a week. Are there days, how many people have had days where I just don't want to go to school? I'd say about everybody. But we end up going to school many of those times because we're being obedient to our parents. But it's also the right thing to do. It's a sacrifice sometimes because we really don't want to be there sometimes. But we go because it's the right thing to do. We go out of love, to be together, to learn, to grow in that knowledge. Especially here, to be able to grow in that knowledge and understanding of our Lord. That's an important thing to do. How many people here love going to Mass all the time? Quite a few, great. How many people sometimes on a Sunday or Saturday night go, I don't want to go to church? Got some of those too. You know, and that's understandable, but we go out of love. We go because to be obedient, because Jesus said at the Last Supper, besides what we hear today about loving one another, he said, do this in memory of me. Continue to do this. And the church has done that since the very beginning. And we continue to do that. And we do that out of love because it's important to be together and celebrate that. You know, Jesus showed his love by gathering a group of friends around him, his disciples, so that they could go out and make communities too. That's an important part of who we are. We don't always love doing it, at least the feeling love, but we can do it out of love because it's the right thing to do. And sometimes it may be a sacrifice. I was just in New York City. I got back this morning at 3 a.m. I was there for a wedding. And it was a great wedding, it was a great celebration, and I was there Friday night for the rehearsal, Saturday for the wedding, and it was really kind of north of New York City a little bit. And so Sunday morning I came into New York City, was staying right around Times Square, and I thought, I need to find a church. So I got on my phone and I just Googled Catholic Church near me. And there was one just like 0.2 miles away from me. So I walked there and celebrated Mass. Now, I didn't necessarily feel like it. I was pretty tired. I just got into the city and I wanted to also figure out how to get down or get up to Yankee Stadium because I went to the Yankees game that afternoon. But I did it because I know it's important. That's what the Lord invites us to love one another, to want the best for each other. And one of the things I encourage you to do this summer, two things. One, always find that opportunity, whether with your parents, or your brothers and sisters, or friends, to put them first sometimes. To not always go with what you want, but what they want and what's important to them. Because that's showing the love that Jesus shows us. And that's the love that is witnessed here this morning. I'm so grateful for your parents and your families who, out of love for you, make sacrifices so you can come here to St. Wenceslaus. I'm grateful for the community here. Those who maybe had kids in school before or don't have any kids who make sacrifices so you can be here at school at St. Wenceslaus. I'm grateful for our teachers and our administrators and our staff who make those sacrifices. They do it out of love for you. And we're invited to imitate that love, the love of Jesus, the love of our parents, the love of others who make those sacrifices and show us that love. And so the first thing, find those opportunities this summer. The second thing I challenge you to do and encourage you to do is come to Mass to celebrate. You guys, I think either yesterday or maybe today, you're going to have some sheets that go home. Sundays for Sundays. You guys did an incredible job with the Rosary Challenge, exceeding by 300 the goal that was set of 1,500 rosaries. What I'm challenged, I'm putting out a challenge, and Unite is putting out a challenge, of 2,500 Masses. And so throughout the summer, whether you're here in Omaha, here at St. Wenceslaus, or going and visiting someplace, to go to Mass and just to record that on that sheet, and then when we come back to school, we're going to see if we reach our goal of 2,500, and then have a Sunday party. Who loves ice cream? Yeah. So I encourage you to do that and challenge you to do that, because it's the right thing to do, and it's a way that we show the love for Jesus, for one another, and being present with one another. Jesus gives us the command. It sounds simple, but it really means sacrifice on our part and imitating his sacrifice. This is my command, he says to us. Love one another. Knowing that God does love us and loves us very much, let us turn and offer our prayers and petitions today, asking him to hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis and all who lead the church, for Pope Francis and all who lead the church, may always feel God's presence working through them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in public office, that they may promote justice and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who bear the cross of pain may never feel forsaken. forsaken by God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all of us may treat one another with kindness, respect, and love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all unborn children, that others will know they are made in God's image, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Grace Gall, who we are remembering during this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the St. Wenceslas community, that we may have a safe summer and stay close to God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Drop beneath, we hold in our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, we ask you to hear all these prayers and those that are unspoken in our hearts. Give answer according to your will, for we offer them through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's be seated now for the preparation of gifts.
Our preparation song is Bind Us Together.
Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this season, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalt in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, George, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. I invite you to stand, and at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your
spirit. Let us offer one another a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song is number 519, By Our Love, number 519.
Let us pray. Hear our Lord our prayers that this most holy exchange by which you have redeemed us may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Invite everyone to be seated for a moment. We have some special blessings and commissionings for each one of the grades. And so when I call your grade level, if you'll stand up and we'll have the blessing and commissioning. So if I could have the kindergartners please stand. I invite everyone here to extend your hands towards the kindergarten as we ask God's blessing upon them and send them forth into the summer. I bless you and encourage you to play safely this summer and to remember that Jesus is present in everyone. Ask Jesus to be with you and to help you in all that you do. Next year you'll be in first grade. May you have a safe and enjoyable summer. Now I ask the first grade to stand. Again, if we extend our hands to each one of them for those seated. I bless you and encourage you to play safely this summer and to remember that Jesus is present in everyone. Next year, you're prepared to receive him in Holy Communion. You can be seated, and I invite the second grade to stand. As you continue to receive our Lord in Holy Communion, I bless you and invite you to pray for others at Mass each week, remembering that we are all one at the Lord's table. Now I invite the third grade. I bless you and encourage you to pray often and to be a friend to everyone you meet. Now I invite the fourth grade. I bless you and encourage you to remember that you belong to God. Be helpful and loving to your families and neighbors this summer. Now the fifth grade. Next school year, you will be members of the middle school. I bless you and invite you to accept your new positions and new responsibilities with happiness and humility. Follow the commandments of the Lord in all you do. Now the sixth grade. As you continue in middle school, I bless you and encourage you to remain steadfast followers of Jesus. Be kind to one another. Now our seventh graders. I bless you and invite you to take your place as the oldest in our school. Be examples of fair play and friendship to all this summer. Remember to be the hands and voice of Jesus to others. And I invite all to stand. After the final blessing, we'll have the dismissal and the closing song. I invite you to stay because we have some awards to give right after Mass. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go forth glorifying the Lord by your lives.
We will sing Stand Up Friends. Please join on the refrain.